in a class of 25 to 30, it is very easy. But at the same time, in a class of 70 to 80, if you take a government school or government aided school, this year I had to meet so many owners and principals. We had a meeting last week. So that time they said all the government aided schools, we must have 60 students per section. But now we are going to have 90 from this year. I said, what is the demand for 90? So they said this year private schools, I don't think y'all would have got more admissions, but the government aided schools have got more admissions because fees is very less. And of course, government aided schools are really doing good in their teaching also. Now, as and how I asked the same question to a principal. So now when you have 90 students inside your class, how are you going to identify the gifted child? Whether your teachers have been given that proper training of analyzing, or whether they are going to, if that particular child is highly knowledgeable and if that child is going to ask a question to your teacher, and if your teacher is unable to answer such a question, will the teacher say, close your mouth and sit down, don't disturb the class? Or will the teacher say truly, my child, I don't know the answer for this, but I will browse and I'll come back and then I will teach? Because private schools, somehow or the other, they grasp those gifted children and they give them more knowledge, and at the same time they highlight them in the school because they get the best results for the school. But when you are going to get that best inside your government aided schools, how are you going to identify? The principal didn't have a question answer for that question. And next is, I said, see, now again, children, now whenever we have lots of programs inside the school, children who are highly talented, they themselves voluntarily, they come and say, ma'am, I can do the programming today. I can work on the lights. I can do the entire program coordination. So every child who has that potential, they are given that free hands to come forward and say. But at the same time, there is a category of children, even though they are highly talented, highly gifted, they don't come out. You know, for the simple reason why they don't come out, it is because of the parents. So if they have to showcase their talent, for example, the child is highly fit and he wants to participate in the state level tournament or national level tournament, but the parent will not be ready to fund the child and send the child for the tournament, for the simple reason the child will be missing the classes, he will not get the best marks. Because see, sports quota we say in colleges, but how many colleges call for the admissions of sports quota? So I have a special zone for the sports quota. Please come forward. So whatever your marks is, but you should have all these medals. So many medals under state, so many medals under national, so many medals under international. You will be given prior importance because Harvard does that. So when Harvard is capable of selecting children from sports category or other category, why not the universities in India also give a special? See, they give area, but the percentage of intake is less for that particular sport. So ultimately, the parent comes to a conclusion, even though my child is talented, I know my child is talented, but now his focus should be only to go to this particular college and he has to study. Or certain, they have their own explanations for why their child, they are stopping. If the child is highly knowledgeable, the parent is happy. But if the child is other than knowledge, if the child is highly talented in other areas, the parent, they themselves, they are not ready to send the children. But this NEP, you will not believe, they have given a very clear-cut area, how to identify the gifted children and how their, their academic does not get collapsed when these both are getting added with them. So I think that place, the NEP has really focused on it and given, but at the same time, see, it is the schools where they have to understand that clearly, explain to the parents, see, don't worry, even if your child is going for all these activities, as the role of the school, what we have to do for your child, we will surely do. If that word goes to the parent also feels, or they take a high pride of exposing their child as a gifted child. Because we have so many children inside our campus who have got international photography awards. They are ambassadors for the youth, international youth, where a child goes for horse riding. So many things are there. But at the same time, they switch over from one school and they come to our school. So when I ask, why did you leave that school? That school is also a very good school. Then they say, no, ma'am, if we come to your school, all the parents who have got experienced like sending their children, but still the children have got the best marks and they are sitting in the best universities and colleges. So that's the reason why we bring. See, what I'm saying is this awareness must be given to all the parents by all the schools. Because when I had to start NIOS, when I told NIOS, many parents, they didn't know NIOS. Everybody thought NIOS is only for differently abled children. So you will not believe I had to give a full page ad only for NIOS, not for SSVM institutions. And I had so many parents meeting. But of course, always when you take the first initiative, you will face failures. But at the same time, I will always say, failure can be for us, we may think. But at the same time, I'm so happy today throughout Tamil Nadu, 95% of the schools are having NIOS inside their campus. Okay. Because now all this is for the gifted children. So the child, their attendance is not a must. At the same time, the child can go explore, experience everything, and they can come and then they can write individually a particular subject and they can clear it. And if they feel that their marks is less also, again, they can upgrade themselves by writing one more test or two more tests and they can go with it. So I'm very clear in India, we have different platforms for education. But as parents, they are aware of only a particular platform and they go only to that platform and they force the children. So if your child is gifted, if you really want your child to have a stress-free education, you have open schooling. So even that has been dealt by the national education policy. And at the same time, no, I want my child to only focus on the content of CBSE because future, I want him to enter UPSC exams. Of course, for that, always CBSE is there. And at the same time, now, because of this national education policy, throughout India, we will have almost the same syllabus, whether it is state or CBSE or union territory. NEP, they have spoken about one, identify the gifted children and develop, mold them to become the teachers. So there also they have focused this point. This one point, I think most of the people have forgotten to note it. They have asked the schools to identify the gifted children and give them a positive counseling to become a teacher. They have not focused on sports. Oh. It is not at all focused on sports. And they have not given clear-cut instruction of how extracurricular activities will be going on. They have given a report card system stating academic area, non-academic area. So under non-academic area, what are the specifications they have never mentioned? I think as days go, they'll be mentioning or what, I don't know. Because when certain areas are not mentioned clearly, it is going to be a difficult task for the school how to go about that. And again, you have here three different platforms. The one is a central educational system. Next is the state educational system. And finally, you have the private educational system. So still, there's a confusion in this policy. What are the contents they are going to follow for the central education system and state education system? And again, they have focused more on the government schools, where they have totally neglected the private schools. So in such a way, we all have to work on it, but still things are, they have told from this year, that is 2020 to 2030, the policy will be revamped and slowly now we have given birth to the baby. The baby has to slowly fall back, crawl, sit. And so ultimately, whatever the changes is there, it is good that it will come back. So whatever we give the feedback, everything is noted. But at the same time, we feel that they have given areas like small areas where you can run the school. So when you are going to focus on small areas on running the school, the child will not have the exposure for sports. So that area has to be clearly mentioned, because digitalization they have given. Of course, tomorrow's world is going to be more digitalized. But the basic thing is physical fitness, which is totally absent in the new educational policy.
Yes, ma'am.
Already, as and how you told, many schools, even sometimes even our teachers, they take the PT period to complete the portions, where at times I will say whether it is really needed, then you all take, because that's only time for them to relax.
Absolutely.
But always they say, no ma'am, somehow or the other we give them time to go and play in the ground. But today, so everything is there. Here, for the teacher to complete the portion on time is, again, the risk falls on the teacher is, what to say, we should not have interruption in the regular schedule.
Absolutely.
When there is interruption in their regular schedule, suddenly there's a calamity, natural calamity, rain and flood. So you will not believe the school closes for 10 days or 15 days or a week. So ultimately that 10 days, 15 days slot gets closed. So
right.
Where the children, when they come back again, the same pressure falls. Now you will not believe, now after this closure, when the school reopens,
yeah.
You will know what all the pressures the teachers are going to face. Now,
yes,
what
yes.
My concern is, children, they should know that even if they don't get time for their physical fitness, they have to create their own games.
Absolutely. Yeah,
but that is now failing, because they are happy on playing with the video games than by going to the ground. So it is 50-50. Sometimes even when I go to the ground, I see children sitting under the tree. So like when I have to ask the children, why are you sitting? They simply say, ma'am, stomach pain, ma'am, leg pain, headache. So children who like to play, always like to play. Children who want to skip out and simply while away the time, they still simply while away the time.
I
so I will always say in this part, we cannot blame the teachers.
Absolutely.
It's only with the cooperation of the students and the environment which have to support them to complete their planned slot for the day. So first the teachers have to inculcate the fitness in them. They have to reduce their obesity.